In this demonstration, we're going to review the network traffic from going to a website and downloading files. I'm adding this to the course after having several questions about extracting files from a network capture file. In this example file we have here showing the results of several connections and downloads of files that have been conducted over the protocol HTTP are represented. As you probably know, if this is over HTTPS, we would have a different look to the data, and we'll review that as well coming up later. The quickest way, and the first way to try and extract the files, is let the Wireshark tool do it for us. Once we have the capture file of interest, we can extract the objects out of it. So we'll attempt this now. In this capture file, we go over here, we click on File, Export Objects, and then you see we've got a number of different protocols here that we can use. So all we're going to do in this case is HTTP, and this shows us all the files that are actually represented in the trace. As we see here, at packet 71, we got an icarm.com .txt. Some of you might know that's the antivirus test file. Then we have a WPSMB plugin.pdf, so we have a PDF file. And then down here at packet 19,684, we have an actual PCAP file. So what we've got here is different types. So you see application, PDF, text, HTML. So this is how you would actually identify files that you want to take a look at. So if we go here and we select one of these files and we save it, it'll come up and save as the name that we're going to give it. Now, normally it's going to save under Wireshark, so we'll move it there, and we'll just save it as test1.pdf. That makes it easy to find. So now we've done that, and then we close. Okay? So now we have the file. This is the actual information here for the file, and that was the process. So now once we do that, we would actually go look at the location where we saved the file to. Before we look at that, let's show you for some of you what it would look like. After Wireshark 1.5, it's now this method of file export objects is there and available for us, which makes it much easier to do. But before that, you would have to manually carve it. So we'll just show you some of the steps of how the actual manual carving process would work. So what we would do is we would actually get in here where the file's at, this application PDF packet is 17,518. We right click it and we follow the stream. Either one, TCP or HTTP, is okay. And as you see here, that PDF, that percent PDF, actually represents the header of the file. So you have to go from the header of the file to the tail of the file. And that's where it gets a little trick, because in this case, there's four different possibilities for the tail of the file. But as I scroll down here, you can see we've got the file contents, and then we get into the actual encoding of the file contents. But you can see the actual font type, TrueType, base font, Calibri, those types of things, italics. So you have quite a bit of information there. Then down here you get into the encoding, and then what you have to do is you have to take all this data here, put it into a hex editor, and find the trailer. And once you find the trailer, then you would actually go about trying to extract it. Now, it's a little bit beyond the scope of what we're trying to do in this demonstration, but if you do want to see that and want me to add that as a future type of demonstration, then by all means, send me a message, and then I can add it into one of the other ones. But for now, we'll just leave it as that. So now that we've done that, we'll go look at our file. So if we go to the D file, and there's our test1.pdf, the file opens, and it's good to go. Okay, so now, this is much easier when it's a text file. So if we go back here to our file, and we go export objects, HTTP, and we do the first one, which is the ICAR file. So once we do the ICAR file, that's packet 71, as we're showing right here, and we right-click it, follow the stream. Now what you'll see is the connection and actually the contents of the file. And this is the contents of the antivirus test file right here. So that antivirus test file is used to test antiviruses. So if you actually go try to do it with this file, your Windows Defender or your antivirus software will delete it. So just be aware of that. I had to disable it to be able to actually download the file. So now what we want to look at is what happens if the connection is HTTPS, all right? So if it's HTTPS, then we're gonna have a little bit of a challenge. So since we know we can use that, we'll go and take a look at it here. So I've actually created another file. If I go File, Open Recent, I've got another file, and here's the exact same ICAR extraction, but this one's using actual transport layer security, as you can see here, TLS version 1.2, which means it's using HTTPS when it connects to the internet. So now when we go file, export objects, we don't have an HTTPS because we can't export. You see, there's nothing in the object list. So this is the exact same actual download of the ICAR file, but it's done over HTTPS. And because of that, we don't have that. So if we close this and we try to find it in the actual network trace itself, we can go through and look and try to find it. And we just right click and we follow the stream, and it's all encrypted. So there's no way we can extract the data out of the actual file. So what you've seen is by using HTTPS, it makes it much more difficult to monitor or do anything. And that's one of our defenses against interception for confidentiality, breaching confidentiality, is to use encryption. And what we've shown here is if you use encryption, then you can't extract the file. So very important that we use HTTPS. And the good news is after the last attacks and everything, we do have HTTPS pretty much being used. And that is the process of how we extract files using the Wireshark tool. As I said, Wireshark's very powerful unless it's encrypted. If it's encrypted, then we can look at some things, but you're going to get into places like this, like where we've got this quick UDP internet connection encrypted, and we go in here, we've got nonce, a random number generator, and we got a payload, but we have to do some form of decryption or decoding to be able to extract that data. And that's the goal as a security professional. We want to make it not clear text. We want to make it harder for the perpetrators or the attackers to be able to extract the information. So what I want to do here is show you how to extract files with Wireshark from PCAP files that HTTP has been used in. We also can do this in SMB. So if we go in here and I bring up my SMB packet capture, I've got an SMB packet capture. It's the same process. I go export objects. Once I go export objects, I go SMB now instead of HTTP. So once I select SMB, there it is. I see I've got an actual plugin. It's a PDF file. It's the exact same process we already followed. So it's just using SMB now. So if we go to the follow TCP stream, it's no longer HTTP. You can see all the Windows stuff in it, Contoso server, which is the standard one for Microsoft. And now we're doing the SMB communications. And we start getting the information, the object information down there. And we start seeing the data. And the data is a PDF. And that's pretty much now, it's the same concept. It's just now we're using SMB as the protocol to transfer the file, like a file server. This is like a file server server would do. Then what you can do is you can actually get the different components of the conversation. So you can get that component of the conversation, or you can get the other side of the conversation, and then you can actually look at it in raw data. If we go look at it in raw data, now it's showing that this is the raw. And what you would do is you would take this raw data, put it into the hex editor, go from the actual point of the header, which in the case of PDF is %PDF. And once you've done that, you'd find the trailer. Once you find the header, cut out the header from the header point to the trailer point, and that would be your file. You'd actually extract it, save it, and then open the file. And that's how we do actual some forms of malware analysis to figure out what files have been transferred by the malware. But again, that's beyond the scope of our demonstration. If it's something you want me to add later, I can always do that. And at this point, we'll conclude the demo.